Today we are going to conduct the starting of three-phase synchronous motor, and also we are going to determine the effect of variation of excitation on three-phase synchronous motor. This is the circuit diagram of three-phase synchronous motor. Here this is the field winding of synchronous motor, and this RYB are the stator winding terminals of synchronous motor. And this is the shaft of a synchronous motor. Here, by using single phase variac and bridge rectifier, we are going to give the DC supply across the field winding of synchronous motor. And by using three phase variac, we are going to give the three phase AC supply to the stator winding terminals of a synchronous motor. And here, by using DC shunt motor, we are going to start the synchronous motor, because synchronous motor is not a self-starting motor. This is our synchronous machine, salient pole synchronous machine. For last three experiments, we have used this synchronous machine as a synchronous generator or alternator. But today we are going to use this synchronous machine as a synchronous motor. This is nameplate details of this synchronous machine. KVA rating is 5 KVA, rated current is 6.9 amperes, 3 phases, star connected stator winding terminals, and 50 Hz supply frequency, 50 Hz frequency, and 1500 RPM, 415 volts is the line to line voltage. These are the nameplate details. And for synchronous generator, we have used the DC shunt motor as a prime mover. For today's experiment, we are using this DC shunt motor as a starter for the three-phase synchronous motor. Now we can see the circuit diagram setup here. This part is for DC shunt motor part. Here we are going to take the 220 volts DC supply, and we are going to give this DC supply to the DC shunt motor through three-point starter. And here it is the field winding of three-phase synchronous motor. We have given a DC supply by using single phase variac and bridge rectifier, and we are going to measure the field winding current by using the 0 to 20 amperes moving coil type ammeter. And these are the RYB stator winding terminals of synchronous motor, and we are going to give the three-phase supply by using the three-phase auto transformer. Three-phase auto transformer input is connected to the three-phase 415 volts 50 Hz AC supply. This is the digital power analyzer. By using digital power analyzer, we can measure voltage, current, frequency, power, active power, reactive power, apparent power, and power factor we can measure. This digital power analyzer having two sensors. One is current sensor, and another voltage probes are there. By using these two probes, we will measure the voltage across these two. Combinedly, it will give the voltage, current, active power, reactive power, apparent power, power factor. These quantities we can measure. How do we measure the current? If we place the conductor in this clamp, then it will give the current through that wire. If you want to measure the voltage, we have to keep these two probes across two terminals, then it will give the voltage across these two stator winding terminals. Means now it will give the line to line voltage. If you want to measure power, we can use this as a 2 watt meter. First we are going to use this as a W1 watt meter. Means we have connected current clamp at R phase, and we have connected voltage probes in RY terminals, and then it will give the W1 reading. If we change the menu, then it will give the W1. Similarly, if we want to measure W2, we have to connect this red color probe to at B phase. then we have to connect this current clamp. Inside this current clamp we have to place the test wire, then it will give the W2. In this way we will measure the power measurements. Now we have set up the connections for the today's experiment. Now we are going to start the three phase synchronous motor by using DC shunt motor. Now we can switch on the MCB. Yes, now we have switched on the MCB. Now by using the 3-point starter we are going to start the DC shunt motor. Now we can see the speed of DC shunt motor is 1439 rpm. By adjusting the external field winding resistance of DC shunt motor we are going to bring the motor speed to 1500 rpm. Now we are going to switch on the and by applying the small voltage in the three phase variac we are going to see the deflection in the moving coil type ammeter which is connected through the field winding. Now we can see the deflection in the moving coil type ammeter, so we have to reduce the three phase auto transformer output voltage to 0 volts, and we have to switch off the supply to the three phase variac, and then we have to change the phase sequence of auto transformer output by interchanging the any two terminals. Now again we are going to switch on the three phase supply for three phase auto transformer. Again we are going to apply the small voltage and we have to see the deflection in the moving coil type ammeter. Now it has given 0 amperes deflection. Now we can switch on the AC supply to the single phase variac. This wire is connected to the single phase auto transformer output is connected to the bridge rectifier, and output of bridge rectifier is connected to the field winding through ammeter. Now we have given the supply voltage to the variac and we are going to give some field winding current. After giving the field winding current we have to adjust the three phase variac and we have to give the 415 volts rated voltage across the stator winding terminal by seeing the digital power analyzer. With the help of digital power analyzer we are measuring the line to line voltage and the current through the armature. We have given the 415 volts across the line to line stator winding terminals. At this condition we have to switch off the DC supply to the DC shunt motor. See the synchronous speed of synchronous motor, it is at 1500 rpm only. Now we have to increase the field winding current and we have to see the armature current. We have to increase the field current to its maximum permissible value such that current through the armature winding of synchronous motor should not exceed the rated current. Now we have increased the field winding current to 20.4 amperes and now we have to note down field winding current and armature current and line to line voltage. At this condition we have to measure the power also. Now here clamp is connected for R phase and voltage probes are connected between R and Y phases. So So it will give the lat meter one reading. So it is 0.97 kilowatt. If you want to measure W2, we have to connect this clamp to B phase, and then we have to measure the W2. It is minus 1.83 kilowatt. Again, we have to connect this to W1, I mean R phase, and this one. Now we have to reduce the field winding current in steps. Now we set the field winding current to 18.4 amperes. At this condition, again we have to see the voltage across the stator winding terminals is 413 volts, 413.3, and current through the armature is 5.67 amperes, and W1 is 0.77 watts. And by reconnecting this clamp and voltage probe, we can note down the W2 is minus 1.56 kilowatts. Again, we are going to reduce the field winding current in step. Now we have adjust the field winding current to 16.16 amperes. At this condition, line to line voltage across the stator winding terminals is 413.1 volt, and current through the armature is 4.31 ampere, and W1 is 0.50 kilowatt, and W2 is minus 1.24 kilowatt. Again, we are going to reduce the field winding current 14 amperes. At this 14 amperes field winding current, line voltage is 413.4 volt, armature current is 3.12 amperes, and W1 is 0.26 kilowatt, and W2 is 0.96 kilowatt. Again, we are going to reduce the field winding current to 12 amperes. For this 12 ampere field winding current, line voltage is 413.2 volts, and armature current is 1.99 amperes. By changing the settings, we can measure the W1. W1 is 0.02 kilowatt, and W2 is minus 0.70 kilowatt. Again, we are going to reduce the field winding current to 10 amperes. At 10 amperes field winding current, voltage is 413.2 volts, current through the armature is 1.06 amperes, and W1 is minus 0.30 kilowatt, and W2 is 0.38 kilowatt. Again, we are going to reduce the field winding current 8 amperes. At this condition, line voltage is 413.4 volt, and the current through the armature is 1.46 amperes, and W1 is minus 0.5 kilowatt, and W2 is 0.12 kilowatt. Now we are going to reduce the field winding current to 6 amperes. At 6 amperes, line voltage is 412.9 volt, and the current through the armature is 2.68 amperes, and and W1 reading is minus 0.88 kilowatt, and W2 is (0.12 kilowatt). Again, we are going to reduce the field winding current to 4 ampere. And 4 ampere field winding current. Line voltage is 412.2 volts, and current through the armature is 4.07 ampere. And W1 is minus 1.21 kilowatt, and W2 is 0.42 kilowatt. Again, we are going to reduce the field winding current to 2 ampere. At 2 ampere field winding current, line to line voltage is 412 volts. And current through the armature is 5.71 ampere, and power W1 reading is minus 1.5859 kilowatt, and W2 reading is 0.72 kilowatt. Again, we have reduced the field winding current. Now the field winding current is 0 ampere. At this 0 amp field winding current, line voltage is 412.1 volt, and current through the armature is 6.88 ampere, and W1 reading is minus 1.88 kilowatt, and W2 reading is 0.92 kilowatt. We have reached the 0 ampere field winding current. Now we are going to reduce the auto transformer, 3-phase auto transformer output to 0 volts. And we are going to switch off the single phase variac, and we are going to switch off the supply for 3-phase variac. From the experiment, we have noted down these experimental values, that is field current, armature current, line voltage, W1 wattmeter reading, W2 wattmeter reading. From W1 and W2, we have determined the total power consumed by the 3-phase synchronous motor. From total power and line voltage and current, we have determined the power factor. If we observe the plot, on x-axis we have taken the field winding current in amperes, on y-axis we have taken the armature current in amperes. If we observe the characteristics, if we decrease the field current from 20.4 amperes to 10 amperes, then armature current is decreasing from 6.76 amperes to 1.06 amperes. If we decrease the field current further, from 10 amperes to 0 amperes, then armature current is increasing from 1 ampere to 6.9 ampere. Shape of this characteristic curve is V curve for a 3-phase synchronous motor.